In this video, I will explain what a blockchain is and what miners are. A blockchain ledger is visualized as a series of blocks which are connected with each other. As you can see, the blocks are connected with each other. Each block is made of a header containing metadata such as its previous block hash, broker root hash, and nonce, followed by a list of transactions. In this example, this block has a header and a list of transactions. The header contains a previous block hash, a broker root hash, and a nonce. The blocks are connected with each other by referencing its parent block hash. In this example, this block has block hash 536, and this block has block hash 890. This particular block is referencing its parent block by its parent block hash. All blocks in the main chain are numbered starting with 0, 1, 2, etc. So this is the main chain, and each block in this chain is numbered. The green block is the first block created and is called the Genesis block and has block number 0. The purple blocks, which forms a short but invalid chain, are blockchain forks, which occur quite regularly. These side forks are also called orphan forks. Bitcoin blocks are created every 10 minutes on average. Ethereum blocks are created every 17 seconds on average. The block height is the number of blocks in the chain between it and the Genesis block minus 1. In this example, the Genesis block has block height 0, this has block height 2, etc. Blocks on side forks can't have the same block height as blocks on the main chain. This block and this block both have block height 2. The same applies to this block and this block. They both have block height 4. And this block, they both have block height 7. Open a browser and go to blockchain.info. In the search box, enter block number 0. This is block number 0, which is the Genesis block. As you can see, this particular block has only one transaction. Now enter in the search box block number 100,000. This is block number 100,000. This particular block has 4 transactions. And you can see these transactions over here. Special nodes on the peer-to-peer network are creating these blocks. These nodes are called miners. All miners are collecting all transactions which people are sending to each other over the network, and only valid transactions are relayed to other nodes. Each miner takes a number of these collected transactions and put them in a newly formed block. This list of transactions are numbered transaction 0, transaction 1, transaction 2, etc. If you look at this particular block, it looks like this, and it contains a list of transactions, and these transactions are numbered transaction 0, transaction 1, etc. The first transaction, transaction 0, is called the Coinbase transaction. This is a transaction where the miner assigns a block reward to his own address. This is how bitcoins are created. For Bitcoin miners, the block reward is 12.5 Bitcoin in 2017. When the Genesis block was created in 2009, the block reward was 50 Bitcoins. For Bitcoin, every 210,000 blocks, the block reward will be halved. Once there have been 64 halvings, the block reward will be 0. There will be a maximum of 21 million Bitcoin in circulation in the year 2140. The other Bitcoin transactions, transaction 1, transaction 2, etc., are ordinary transactions where Bitcoins are transferred from the owner address to a recipient address. Each transaction requires a small transaction fee. This fee will continue to increase as an incentive for the miners to create new blocks because the block reward will continue to be lowered. Open a browser and go back to the blockchain.info website. Enter block number 0, the Genesis block. Here you see the block reward is 50 Bitcoins. Now search for block number 210,000. This is block number 210,000, and the block reward is halved. It is now 25 Bitcoins. Search for block number 420,000. this is block number 420,000. The block reward is yet again halved. It is now 12.5 bitcoins. When the miner has constructed a block, he has to solve a hash puzzle applied on his list of transactions. This list of transactions. The miner who has first solved the hash puzzle is allowed to broadcast his block on the network. The block also includes the solution to the puzzle, also called the nonce, in the block header. Here, the nonce is included in the block header. If you go back to block number 420,000, you will see the nonce over here. This nonce is a solution to the hash puzzle. In a later video, I will explain more about the nonce. Other miners on the network will receive this block and they validate this block before they append it to their chain of blocks. It happens regularly that another valid block is broadcasted on the network because another miner has solved the puzzle at nearly the same time. When this happens, temporary forks are created, for example, fork A and fork B. So this is fork A and this is fork B. Let's assume 2/3 of the miners on the network are working on fork A and the rest on fork B. In this example, fork A becomes the main chain because it consists of the longest series of blocks from the Genesis block. Miners should always work on the longest chain. Blocks on fork B, these two blocks, will be orphaned. In this example, this fork with this particular block is orphaned. These two blocks on this fork is also orphaned. And this is the main chain. The miner who has solved the hash puzzle and his block is on the main chain means that this miner received the block reward and also all the transaction fees in his block. The miner who has solved the hash puzzle and his block is on an orphaned fork cannot spend the block reward and transaction fees because his block is not on the main chain. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. If you have questions, leave your comments below. I'll do my best to answer them.